Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we're going to learn how to design and 3D print an enclosure for a Wemos D1 mini board using Fusion 360 software. Without any further delay, let's get started. A few months back, I bought my first 3D printer, a Wonhao Duplicator i3. Since then, I was 3D printing some files that I have downloaded from the internet, but I wanted to learn how to design my own things. I tried a lot of different 3D design software, but Fusion 360 became my favorite for the following reasons. It is very powerful, it is absolutely free, it is very easy to use, and there are a lot of tutorials online on how to use this software. As you are going to find out, designing this enclosure won't take us more than 5 minutes from start to finish on Fusion 360. First of all, we have to download the Fusion 360 software. You will find a download link in the description of the video. After the download is complete, we have to set up the software and create an Autodesk free account. When you open Fusion, select the trial counter in the upper toolbar. It will appear up here. I am already registered, so it does not appear in my machine. If you press it, you can select Register for free use and you can register as an enthusiast, which is free. That's it, our software is set up and ready to use. First, we are going to make a sketch of our enclosure based on some measurements of the D1 mini board. On a white paper, I draw the outline of the board and I write down the measurements from a caliper. So, it's 35.3mm by 27mm. Let's now measure the Z dimension, it's around 6mm. Now that we have the exact dimensions of the board, we can design the enclosure in Fusion 360. On a new design, we press the Create Sketch button, a very powerful tool of Fusion. Now select the plane to draw on. We select this plane. From the Sketch menu, we select the 2-point rectangle. We place it on the center and we enter the dimensions of the board. This is going to be the inside of the enclosure. We make it a little bigger than the actual dimensions. So I enter 36mm here and 27.5 here and I click to place it. Now let's make the enclosure 3mm thick. We go to Sketch Offset. Then we select the rectangle we have designed. We move it this way in order to create a bigger rectangle and we enter 3mm. This will be the thickness of the walls of the enclosure. We now press the Stop Sketch button. Now we go to the Create menu and we select the Extrude command. We then select the small rectangle and we extrude it upwards by 3mm. That's the base of the enclosure we are going to create. Now let's make the walls. We enable the Sketch 1 again and we now select the big rectangle. We extrude it by 13mm. A simple enclosure just appeared. Now let's make an opening for the USB cable. From my measurements it has to be around 17mm in width. So we select the front face of the enclosure and then we click to create a new sketch to it. We create a rectangle with a width of 17mm and a height of 10mm and we place it at the center. You can always move a sketch with a left click and by selecting the move action. We then press the Stop Sketch button again. We then select the new rectangle and we press the Extrude button and we enter -3mm extrusion. The opening has been created. By pressing the home icon here, we return to the default view of the model. I now select this face in order to create two more rectangles in order the D1 Mini to sit in and leave some space at the bottom for the wires. So I create a 2-point rectangle here and a smaller one close to the USB opening. Then I press the Stop Sketch button and I extrude both rectangles, one by 5mm and the other by 3mm. I discovered these values by trial and error, since the D1 Mini has an irregular height. The last step is to create a small hole for the wires. We turn the model around by holding down Shift and pressing the middle button of the mouse. We select the back face of the enclosure and we press the Create Sketch button. We create a 2-point circle. We set the diameter of the circle at 4 mm. We stop the skids and we extrude this way in order to create the hole. That's it! The bottom of the enclosure is ready. Let's print it. I am going to print the part using ColorFab's white PLA. While the part is printing, let me tell you about the new Android game I have developed. Since 2014, I develop mobile games for a living, and a few months ago, I developed a new game which is called Quiz of Knowledge. It is a quiz game developed for Android, which contains thousands of multiple choice questions, supports 6 languages, and it is completely free. If you like quiz games, you can download Quiz of Knowledge from the Google Play Store now by clicking here or by following a link for the game in the description of the video. Thanks! 50 minutes later, the part is ready, and as you can see, the Wemos D1 mini board fits nicely in it. Now it is time to design the top part of the enclosure, which is much easier. All we have to do is to create a new sketch and draw a 2-point rectangle. The dimensions of it must be the same with the bottom, so we enter 42 mm and 33.5 mm. We stop the sketch and we extrude it by 2 mm. If we move it in place, we can see that it fits perfectly. Now, with the same procedure, we design a circle with a diameter of 5.1 mm for the LED, and we extrude it by minus 2 mm in order to create a hole. If you wish, you can also make some openings like this by sketching some rectangles. The top of the cover is ready. Let's print it. 20 minutes later, our simple enclosure is complete. Of course, there are a lot of improvements that can be made to this design. This is just a demonstration that within minutes and with little knowledge of the Fusion 360 software, we can achieve great results. With tools like 3D printers, we can now move our projects to another level. I am very excited with the 3D printing technology and the applications of it. I am very new to 3D design, and as I learn more design tricks with the software, I will share them with you with tutorials like this one. I would love to hear your opinion about Fusion 360. Have you used it in any of your projects, and do you have any tricks to share with us? Please post your comments in the comment section below. Thank you! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things, and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.